good morning and a very warm welcome to you all as we gather at India House today for the celebration of India's 72nd Independence Day. We are going to begin with the hoisting of the tricolour. So may I now request all the people who are seated in front to kindly gather around the flag right at the back and kindly switch off your mobile phones or put it on silent mode. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, may I now request you all to proceed towards the front and take your seats close to the podium as we continue with the remaining program. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as we proceed with the program, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you once again to India House for the celebration of India's 72nd Independence Day. 71 years ago this day, at the stroke of midnight, India broke away from the shackles of colonization and took its rightful place in the Committee of Free Nations. 71 years on now, we are in the process of taking our rightful place amongst the global leading powers. So it is an honor, as I said, to welcome you today on this auspicious occasion. I now have the pleasure and the honor to invite Ambassador of India, His Excellency Navtej Sarna, to deliver the message of the Honorable President on the occasion of India's 72nd Independence Day. Thank you.
Namaskar. My warmest greetings to you on our 72nd Independence Day. And thank you all for joining this flag hoisting ceremony today and celebrating it together with all of us. The Honorable President of India has already delivered his address to the nation, and copies of this address will be available for you. So I would only read out one extract, and this is a particularly significant Independence Day, if we can ever grade Independence Days amongst themselves. And the reason is that in a few more weeks, in 6 weeks, we will begin the 150th birth anniversary of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. So let me read out that portion of the President of India's speech which deals with the significance of this anniversary. Dear fellow citizens, Independence Day is always special, but this year there is an unusual significance attached to it. In a few weeks, on 2nd October, we will begin the commemoration of the 150th birthday of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji did not just lead our freedom struggle, he was and still is our moral compass. In my capacity as the President of India, I have been fortunate to have travelled around the world, particularly to a few countries of Africa. Everywhere across continents, Gandhiji is mentioned, cherished and remembered as an icon for all humanity. He is the embodiment of India. It is not always simple to understand Gandhiji. He refused to be restricted in his definition of politics and political activism, or even of freedom. When Gandhiji and his wife Kasturba traveled to Champaran in Bihar for the Indigo Farmers Agitation, they devoted a considerable part of their time to educating local people, particularly women and children, as well as teaching them about hygiene and health. Here and on other occasions, Gandhiji personally led the drive for Swachhta or cleanliness. He linked the removal of dirt to an act of self-discipline and of promoting physical and mental health. Many were puzzled at that time. What does all this have to do with freedom? For Gandhiji, they were the centerpiece of the quest for freedom. This was a struggle, according to him, not just for political power, but for empowering the poorest of the poor, educating the uneducated, ensuring the right to a dignified life and a feasible livelihood for every village, for every neighborhood, for every family, and for every individual. Gandhiji spoke of Swadeshi with an uncommon zeal. To him, this was a pride in promoting Indian creativity and an Indian sensibility. Nevertheless, he was alive to intellectual currents from the rest of the world. He invited these to enrich our learning. To him, Indian civilization was defined by open windows and not closed doors. This was his concept of Swadeshi, and it is still relevant to us as we engage with the world, whether for our economy, our health, education and social aspirations, or our policy choices. Perhaps Gandhiji's most noble mantra was to point out that the power of ahimsa is far greater than the power of hinsa. The power to stay your hand is far greater than the power to strike with your hand, and hinsa has no place in society. The weapon of ahimsa was the most effective weapon Gandhiji gave us. Like his other teachings, it was rooted in the ancient wisdom of India and yet has a resonance in the 21st century and in our daily lives. This Independence Day, so close to the 150th anniversary commemoration of Gandhiji, let each of us adopt his ideas and maxims in whatever manner we can in our everyday work and conduct. I can think of no better way to celebrate our freedom. I can think of no better way to celebrate Indianness. And this Indianness is not for us alone. It is part of what our country and our civilization bring to the global stage. In the spirit of Gandhiji and the spirit of India, we believe in the age-old ideal of Vasudeva Kutumbakam, or the world is one family. That is why we demonstrate our concern for entire humanity by providing assistance to many African countries, taking initiatives on the issue of climate change, contributing to UN peacekeeping operations in different parts of the world, helping neighboring countries affected by natural disasters, rescuing people from other countries along with our own people trapped in conflict zones. In the spirit of Gandhiji and the spirit of India, we share the practice of yoga for health and well-being and using technology for development. We are Gandhiji's children. We dream for all humanity, even when we walk alone. Thank you. That was the extract from the Honorable President of India. I must say that the Government of India has elaborate plans for celebrating the 150th birth anniversary through the entire year. There will be several events, there will be several programs, and there will be several outreach efforts by the embassy, and I would urge you all to participate in these. I see a lot of young people in the audience, and that is very heartening. 50% of India's population is under the age of 25, so the future belongs to all of you. But I think this particular year, I think particularly for the young people, if I have a personal message, it would only be to read about Gandhiji and to read about the freedom struggle of India. Because by the time all of you reach adulthood and beyond, you will be celebrating 100 years of India's independence. And I think a knowledge, a deep knowledge and understanding of where we came from will help us to know where we are going. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador. That is indeed an inspiring message for us all. In the run-up to the Independence Day, Embassy of India had organized two competitions at the India International School, Virginia on 4th August. I'm sure you all know about the India International School in Virginia. It is a non-profit and equal opportunity educational institution serving the community since 1982. Now, out of these two competitions, one was a speech competition on the subject India of My Dreams, and the other a competition on rendition of patriotic songs. Both the events saw enthusiastic participation by children. I now invite Ambassador to kindly step on stage and award certificates and gift cards to the winners of the two competitions. I will also request the winners, as I call out their names, to kindly step up and accept the honor from the Ambassador. For the speech competition on the subject India of My Dreams, the winners are Lara Shan Ocha and Akhilesh Mahesh. Please step on stage. A big round of applause for the winners, please. Akhilesh Mahesh. In the patriotic song competition, the winners are Grace Paul Neher Gurudatta, Neher Gurudatta. Rhea Chawla. And Hasini Koti Naduni. A big round of applause, please. I will now request all the winners to kindly have a group photograph with Ambassador. All six of you, please kindly step up. A round of applause for all the winners, please. They did an amazing job. Thank you. Thank you. Moving on, I will now invite the winners of the patriotic song competition, Grace Paul, Neher Gurudatta, and Rhea Chawla, to present the rendition of our national song, Vande Mataram. Please welcome them on stage.
Shamalam ಮಲಯಜ ಶೀತಲ ಸಸ್ಯ ಶ್ಯಾಮಲ ಮಾತರಂ ವಂದೇ ಮಾತರಂ ಕೋಟಿ ಕೋಟಿ ಕಂಠ ಕಲ ಕಲ ನಿನಾದ ಕರಲಿ ಕೋಟಿ ಕೋಟಿ ಪೂಜೆ ಕೃತ ಕರ ಕರವಾಲಿ
of Vande Mataram by our talented young kids. A big round of applause for them. Before we proceed further, I have the honor to recognize the presence of Dr. Subha Rao, a well-known freedom fighter in our midst. Please accept the thanks of a grateful nation. Now, I have the pleasure to invite the young talented singers from the Gandharva School of Music to present a medley of patriotic songs followed by a rendition of Sare Jahan Se Acha. A few words about the Gandharva School of Music. It is the first Indian music school and first overseas center affiliated with the prestigious Akhil Bharatiya Gandharva University. The school is committed to the propagation of Hindustani classical music and dance and offers a 7-year progressive certificate program. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage the talented young singers of Gandharva School of Music. We have with us Argya Shetty, please step up, Ashni Shetty, Avni Abhyankar, Prakhar Mathur, Priyanka Mathur, and they will be accompanied on the tabla by Tushar Gayali and on the harmonium by Shreyas Bhalle.
You're में खेलती है जिसकी Thank you.
applause for the budding young artists of the Gandharva School of Music. This brings us to the conclusion of today's program. I thank you all for coming out today and joining us in the celebration of this auspicious occasion, India's 72nd Independence Day. Now please join us for light refreshments served at the back in the patio. And once again, I wish you all a happy Independence Day. Jai Hind.
Sashya Shama.